Union Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari has said that he would be taking legal action on anti-social elements, in his words, who have made bizarre comments attributing personal motives to me regarding the assassination threat to Prime Minister, unquote. Now, this reaction has come after former JNU Students Union leader Shehla Rashid hinted at Gadkari's role specifically at allegedly plotting to assassinate Prime Minister Modi. Shehla Rashid wrote on social media site Twitter, and I quote, "Looks like RSS Gadkari is planning to assassinate Modi, blame it on Muslims and communists and then lynch Muslims," unquote. Let me go across to National Affairs editor Rahul Srivastav. Rahul, Shehla is a famous face, and with this bizarre conspiracy theories, what is the reaction coming in now?
Pooja, if you see over the last few days, there have been in news a very clear insinuation through letters which have come out that there was much more to the agitations which have been happening and the role of certain left organizations. I think somewhere it's in line with that, that perhaps Shehla has thrown a counter. And Nitin Gadkari, the Surface Transport and Shipping Minister, is extremely unhappy at the insinuation. And I have spoken to sources very close to Mr. Nitin Gadkari. He's already consulting senior lawyers. He's taking legal advice, and he will be moving the courts and put up a strong defamation case against Shehla Rashid. What he is saying is that not only is the entire charge preposterous, it totally exploits the basic right of freedom of speech just to hurl an accusation at somebody in a public office.
And Rahul, Shehla Rashid would be well within her freedom of speech, so to say, in this country to question the letter that was sourced and whether it was even a plant or whether it was real. That would be fair. But to really name a transport minister and say that this is all a conspiracy to eventually lead to riots is too strong and provocative a statement.
I think it is right from the attempt is to be preposterous. To attempt is to counter what has come out through legitimate means. These are exposes which have come out from raids and police activities and actions. And after that, if there is to be a counter, the counter cannot be blasphemous or libelous. It cannot question the integrity and in such a manner that an attempt to assassinate a prime minister is a very serious charge.
And also tell us what precisely has been happening in the past few days. Why has this reaction come from Shehla Rashid at all? Because what was that letter that was sourced in the past few days?
You see, there have been certain exposes out in the media by following police action in which letters have been seized, which do claim that there was an attempt in terms of funding, in terms of destruction of normal activity, creating agitations which create social unrest, and to the extent of attacking the Prime Minister of the country. Now, these are things which came out in police raids. They can be denied. Anybody who is who's charged in those letters or through those letters has a right to legal counsel. But the fact is, to use that to throw a counter by charging a sitting minister in government.
Rahul, please hold on, because I am joined by former JNU Students Union leader Shehla Rashid on phone. Shehla, you are a famous face, and you know each statement that you make will be retweeted thousands of times. You already have followers. How can you put forth a bizarre conspiracy theory and even naming a politician like that, Shehla?
See, first of all, it's not a conspiracy theory. It's precisely the point that I wanted to make is sarcastic. That, you know, you are, I mean Times Now. Times Now...
Well, we're not taking names here. We're not taking names of other channels,
no,
Shehla. But what is your view?
That's what the context is, no? That's what the context is. So we have to say that. Times Now uses an entire show to defame Umar Khalid and his father and indicate that they are trying to assassinate Modi. Now, you know what is bizarre? That is bizarre.
So then you name Gadkari instead.
Hang on. This is a sarcastic tweet. There is no need to get worked up about this. And precisely, this is precisely the reaction that I was waiting for.
See, Shehla, you need to understand here.
Just let me complete in one go, okay? So first of all, what I need to say is that all these conspiracy theories that are being peddled, that Umar Khalid is trying to kill Modi and Umar Khalid's father is involved or whatever.
Yes.
all this is being done to hide the economic failures, the socio-economic failures of the Modi government.
Okay.
And Modi is just trying to look like a victim now by using his B-team channels to peddle these conspiracy theories that he's been trying to, you know, he's being assassinated or whatever. Now, to use Umar Khalid's name, who is a vulnerable student, he does not have the backing of the world's biggest party, BJP, which Mr. Nitin Gadkari has, so he should not get worked up.
Okay.
He has a very big platform available to him. But Umar Khalid does not have that. And that is precisely the point that I wanted to make, that if Mr. Gadkari feels so bad, and his name has been picked, you know, just to make the point, just to make a sarcastic point, that if you feel so bad,
yes,
imagine how Umar Khalid would be feeling. And if you want to take action against Rahul Shivshankar, who has done an entire episode.
Shehla, you are well within your rights to question, to deny any letter that has come into the public domain. You're well within your rights to stand by your contemporary Umar Khalid. But the question that I'm trying to ask you here is, if at all you're trying to deny or counter a certain letter, objectionable as it may seem to you, is it as much fair for you to counter it with, as you call it, sarcasm? Is this the political discourse you also want to peddle as a probable next generation politician?
The point that I'm trying to make here is that if Mr. Gadkari's name looks random, then Mr. Umar Khalid's name is just as random. And we don't question the latter because Umar Khalid is Muslim. So he's like, you know, he's a terrorist by default. He's an anti-national by
default. Who said that, Shehla?
But we... times now. That is the narrative that is being peddled. All these fake letters that are being put out in the public domain, this can create a lynching, mob lynching kind of atmosphere for people like Umar Khalid, who are already vulnerable, who are victims of state repression, and whose name is being raked up out of nowhere.
Well, clearly Umar Khalid also has said that he has received threats, and so has Jignesh Mevani, and all of you are clearly very significantly raising that point, and we are going to, of course, stand by you if you're receiving any threats. But as a young politician as well, Shehla, this is only going to make the political discourse much worse, because you've already been retweeted so many times. And just to make a comparison, do you think this was a fair comparison to make?
It's not a comparison, it's a sarcastic point. I mean, I am ready to apologize to Mr. Gadkari, but is Times Now, is Rahul Shivshankar ready to apologize to Umar Khalid? You know, there is this problem. Times Now and Times of India, they ran an entire campaign suggesting that Najib Ahmed, who is a missing JNU student, you know, just because...
Shehla, I will not be able to discuss another channel's prerogative here. All I can say is, at India Today, I would love to have your view, but that view also needs to be defended with some logic.
No, you can very well run it, because it's factual. No, I'm not making something up. I'm not dreaming up a fairy tale. Times Now did run an entire bulletin on Umar Khalid. That's true, you know, that's there, and this is a response to that.
Okay, and now Nitin Gadkari is saying that he's going to take likely legal action. His office has confirmed. How do you counter that?
That is exactly my point. I want to make him feel like that. You know, if he can feel that way, I want him to empathize with a vulnerable Muslim student, Umar Khalid, and try to make him understand how he must be feeling. I mean, this is just a sarcastic tweet which has some 1,000 people.
So why Gadkari? I want to know that.
National TV. When national TV, it's just a random meme, you know. And if Nitin Gadkari's name is random, so is Umar Khalid's. His name is totally random. It is being dragged because it just sensationalizes the whole issue. It's a Muslim name. It just sells, you know. We don't raise the question in the same manner that why Umar Khalid's name is being raked up, you know, because he's Muslim, he's fair game.
Well, absolutely. Nobody is blaming Umar Khalid if there is a random name that has cropped up. We cannot take accountability
not,
of
surely.
Another channel. Yes, Shehla,
yeah, no,
but
you are not.
But on India Today, I would want to know that if Umar Khalid didn't raise that sarcastic tweet, what prompted you to make that, as you call it, sarcasm and a random name?
No, see, I don't. Umar Khalid speaks for himself, I speak for myself. I just feel that there is a need to question this official narrative that is being peddled. You know, there is no way for us. So, for example, I made a tweet and I am available for questioning. You know, you are questioning me, fine, I'm accountable. But what about the official narrative? You know, you just hold up a random letter in the air, up in the air, and you just show it on national TV prime time. And no one has the means to question it. There is no means to question it. So what my point is that it's important to question the state narrative on this whole assassination plot, because if everyone is peddling conspiracy theories...
But how do you know that it is a random letter also, Shehla? How do you know that it is a plant? What if...
Because Modi government has completely failed to deliver on any promises even to their own constituents. And this assassination plot is just a move to divert attention from that. And I'm just trying to make a point here to show how silly it is. You know, if it is silly to bring up a Gadkari's name, it is silly to bring up Umar Khalid's name. And just because the latter has a Muslim name, we, you know, it's not that we should not question this. If we are questioning why Gadkari's name
do you at any cost, Shaila, now that this has become such a massive controversy and you may also be served a legal notice, and you, if you are yourself saying that it was merely sarcasm, it was random, do you think you would want to rephrase that social media reaction? Would you want to rephrase that word? Do you at any level are having double and second thoughts about it?
Well, you know, the thing is, see, we have spent the last 3 to 4 years countering this kind of media narrative against us. And of course, I'm not clubbing all media together, but we know which media channels those are. These are working as the B team of Modi. And when Najib Ahmed was branded an ISIS sympathizer, we did not have the money to counter that allegation. You know, we did not have the money to file that defamation case. Now, BJP has a lot of money. They have made a lot of money through all these scams that they have done.
Okay, Shaila,
they are welcome to sue me.
Shaila, hold on, because Rahul Srivastava, who had some information from Nitin Gadkari's office, he's our national affairs editor, has a question for you. Rahul, please go ahead.
Pooja, what I would like to ask Shaila Rashid, that she has a much more than a nodding acquaintance to the law of the land. She knows that Umar Khalid, if a X channel has been incorrect in its news reporting against Mr. Umar Khalid, as a citizen of this country, has a protection of law.
Absolutely.
He can challenge the court. But Shaila Rashid deliberately bringing in Nitin Gadkari and RSS is not as innocent a remark, I think. I think, Shaila ji, your remark is deliberate, because there it was a question was raised in those letters against the left. You wanted to involve the RSS. You chose Mr. Nitin Gadkari because Mr. Nitin Gadkari has a certain association, old association with the RSS. Now, if Mr. Umar Khalid does not have the money like the BJP, but the state provides counsel in this country. The terrorist Kassab from Pakistan was given legal counsel.
Why are you comparing
it was
Umar
not
Khalid
that he was left unprotected.
Why are you comparing Umar Khalid to Kassab?
I'm not comparing. I'm saying
you
that the law
did.
Of the land is open.
You know, you just did. And you're questioning me. You know, first you need to question your own biases.
Shaila, that is not a bias. What
I'm
trying to tell you,
I'm trying to say, as well as the case.
The moment we hear a Muslim name, we just go crazy. That's the problem. You know, you need to stop making that comparison and then asking that.
But also, Shaila, if there is a letter that has been sourced, how are you so sure?
I don't believe the letter.
It is merely a plot. How are you so sure that it is a fake
letter? You know, I don't believe the official narrative. I'm sorry, I don't believe the official narrative on it. What is the accountability? You know, are we supposed to? You can ask me questions and I can clarify. But how can we ask questions of the state? Can we ask questions of the channels that are, you know, peddling the state narrative? I think we need to question
well,
that.
Well, Shaila, I think, as I say, India is still a democracy, and as of now, you have as much freedom as anybody else, and you will be as much accountable as anybody else. I'm also now joined by a BJP leader who's saying that you're just playing a victim card, and you're not really, this was not the tweet that it should have come, as you call it, merely sarcastic and random. We have to be more responsible with social media. Anila Singh, what do you want to ask Shaila? She stands by her statement.
Actually, everybody knows that what type of mindset Shaila has. I am not at all surprised. And whole of the India knows that what is RSS and who is Nitin Gadkari.
RSS is a terrorist organization. That is what RSS is.
How? If you would like to,
this
in fact, clarify.
Shaila, I think, so, I think you, have lost your, you have lost your senses. Shaila, I think you have lost your senses. You don't know
RSS
that what you are talking, what you are tweeting, and what you are saying about
RSS
who.
RSS members are convicted for terror activities. It is just that simple. You know, RSS members are convicted for terror activities.
And as Shaila, members of
RSS
several other groups and several other communities.
Everybody knows what Shaila is, and everybody knows that what she keeps on trying to do and what type of mindset she has. And it is totally bizarre.
What mindset do you have? What golden mindset do you have?
And she has to face the heat of it. Now she has to face the heat of it.
You worship Aseema Anand. You worship Sadhvi Pragya. You
worship this country, Shaila, not... We worship this country, unlike you. You eat and drink and breathe of this country, and then you talk totally against what country is.
Sadhvi Pragya is from your organization.
So country wants to know from you that what nationalism is, and you are going to say that RSS and Nitin Gadkari, they wanted to kill Prime Minister of this country.
Anila, thank you for your words. We will give Shehla also.
Complicit in terror planning.
Yes, we'll give Shehla also the view and the time to respond.
What do you have to say about that?
Shehla, we'll definitely give you the time, and we also want to know what prompted you to that reaction. But you know, clearly there are reactions from BJP, and I'm glad that you continue to stay with us. In fact, Nupur Sharma from BJP is also joining me now. Nupur, she said it was only to make people react and see how they are comparing Umar Khalid without any evidence.
You know what, I don't really care what she says in defense, but I do care about what she tweeted. And as the Honorable Union Minister has rightly actually said, that we are going to take legal action, and all of this explanation and defense and all that will have to be actually put on record before the courts. Now that's one. Secondly, I certainly want to actually make a comment of my own. The kind of conspiracy theories and bizarre comments that are actually coming out goes on to show that maybe these people know a lot more, because the fact is that either they feel that they're threatened because they're getting exposed with the letters that are now a part of a judicial procedure in the courts in Pune and Maharashtra. Secondly, all these unfounded baseless allegations and claims to know, oh, there is a plot like this and that, that actually go on to show, are you an accessory? Are you just trying to cover up for what is actually
going on? Shehla, you want to respond to that?
Now a legal path of a judicial proceeding in Pune. This is not a small thing. It's a very, very big allegation.
Shehla, do you want to take that question?
Allow me to let her finish.
Nupur, let her answer.
Allow me to complete. And so Ms. Rashid has a lot to answer now before the courts of law of India.
Well, the thing is, I think that the assassination plot letter was put out not by us. It was put out by the right wing, and you don't want me to name channels, but everyone knows which channels they are. And I think that they are using this as an accessory to actually hide the failures of the Modi government. And who knows whether RSS is actually planning something or not, I don't know. But this assassination plot, it's, first of all, I don't believe this. This is utter nonsense. The other thing is, this is being peddled. You know, there have been attacks. You know, when Modi went to Bihar for a rally, there was a low intensity attack before his Hunkar rally that he was doing in Bihar. So they have done these things before. But the question
but
is,
Shehla, so are your friends Jignesh Mevani and Umar Khalid are also saying that they are receiving threats, they are receiving death intimidations, and they are only
so
making claims as
point.
Much.
That's a different point. That this assassination plot, I mean, I'm not the one to peddle a conspiracy theory. The conspiracy theory is coming from the state side, first of all. And that is the accessory here that is being used to hide Modi government's failures. It is just that simple. Modi government is at the lowest ebb of its popularity.
So if as a leftist leader...
And this is being used as a sympathy-gaining tactic. They just want to, you know, they are invoking Rajiv Gandhi and whatever. And this is all, I don't believe the state narrative on this. This is just a ploy to... win back some lost.
As a leftist leader, if you and your friends and of course other contemporary left leaders feel that they are very different from the BJP and RSS with regard to the moral high ground, why would you use the same tactic for social media to add to the hysteria, Shehla? You're just adding to that hysteria.
No, I'm not. I mean, if you see my tweet, the tweet before that, and then you see the next tweet, it's very clear that it's sarcasm. And I just want them to feel, I mean, you see how BJP leaders and BJP spokespersons are worked up right now. Just imagine what would be the, you know, environment in Umar Khalid's family. His father is being shown on national TV. He is being shown on national TV alongside the story.
You must go to court, Shehla. I'm sure you have resources. I'm sure criminal defamation doesn't cost a lot of money.
That's like saying that factory owners, you know, factory workers are free to buy the factory. That's that kind of an argument. That's a liberal argument. We did not have the resources to go to court when Najim Ebenepoel branded an ISIS terrorist. You know, we did not have the resources. And this has not happened to Umar Khalid first time. When during the JNU struggle, during the sedition controversy, he was branded, you know, by some channels, he was branded a Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorist. And it was said that that is the IB. The information has come from IB. Now, can we question the IB? If he is indeed a Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorist, why is he not in jail? You know, this is all nonsense. You know, BJP wants to win the 2019 elections just based on this hysteria. And after that, there will be no charge sheet. Where is the charge sheet in the sedition case, for example? Nowhere. This is just the hysteria is being ripped up.
If you do believe in law here, if you do believe in the way law of the land works here in this country, then you need to also keep faith. Like if the sedition cases were gone, then this as well as a letter that had come confirmed by the police, which you're free to not believe and which you're free to counter at any moment.
I do believe in the democratic setup. What I don't believe in is the ruling party narrative. I don't believe in that. Sure, the sedition case was fake. We know that by now because there is no charge sheet. But based on that case, you know, that case has been used by BJP in 17 states to campaign for their elections, you know, and they have won election after election based on just one narrative that we are the nationalists and they are the anti-nationalists. You know, they are just going to use this narrative
but
now.
But to be fair as well, Shehla, often Umar Khalid has made a lot of statements with regard to, you know, clearly which would lead in many ways to sedition charges. So let's not go there. But at least with you specifically, because you have made that statement on social media, I would want to ask you, you're fairly going into now political issues. You may be joining the mainstream parties very soon. What kind of impact is Shehla Rashid leaving? She is only making statements similar to that of probably the ruling party, as you say, to clearly make more hysteria without any evidence. You are clearly making random statements just so you can get back. How many people even understand sarcasm on social media, Shehla?
Well, maybe through your channel, they will try to understand the point that I'm trying to make. The impact that I want to leave is I want to remove this anti-Muslim prejudice and anti-Muslim stereotypes that are being peddled by various channels. You don't want me to name them, fine, by various channels. Everyone knows who those channels are. They are peddling anti-Muslim hysteria on a daily basis. And I just want to expose how ridiculous that is. Because when we see a Muslim name, the automatic reaction is, oh, well, terrorist.
Shehla, I would like to disagree with you there. I do not think that the manner in which you're stating that channels are peddling that, the fact that Umar Khalid is free to counter argument just like you are, we are still a democracy, and whether or not this was a victim card, whether or not this was a sarcastic tweet, I wish you well, Shehla Rashid, for getting out that statement, and probably more courage to you if you want to fight back any ruling party's politics, so to say. Thank you so much, Shehla Rashid, for joining us on India Today and taking all the questions.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.